Alright, today let's talk about the semblances of Team Coffee and how they might evolve throughout the RWBY series as Team Coffee continues to train and get stronger at Shade Academy, and what they might become by the end of the RWBY series. Now today I want to talk about Coco, Fox, and Velvet, and leave Yatsuhashi for his own video, as his semblance has a little bit more to do with his past, and also is a bit more unique and could have different implications for the RWBY storyline depending on how it's used. Now, every member of Team Coffee had their semblance revealed and expanded upon and explained in the book After the Fall, how it relates to their personality, how they handle themselves in fights, and for a couple of them, how their weapons have been chosen to fit perfectly with their semblances. Now, the three we're going to discuss today, Coco, Fox, and Velvet, all three of their semblances have been shown in the actual RWBY series itself, even though we may not have known it at the time, and at least for one of them, there was no way that we could have known. Now, I'll explain to this when we get to that point, but let's start off with Coco Adel. Now, she is a very strong person, both mentally and physically, easily seen by the little handbag that she carries that turns into a freaking Gatling gun that can mow down Grimm like no tomorrow. Now, one thing that we see in volumes 2 and 3 is that when she fires her Gatling gun, it destroys Grimm. The first bullet that hits a Grimm slices Nevermore's in half and just decimates them. Now, other bullets, like RWBY's high-powered sniper rifle, yeah, it hits the Grimm, but doesn't always do that much damage. Now, that I always had chalked up to, you know, Coco's gun being a Gatling gun, but not necessarily true. Now, we've known since Volume 1 that everyone's weapon in the RWBY universe is a conduit for aura, that every bullet fired from a gun is charged with a certain amount of aura, that a person's weapons are using their aura as well. But in Coco's case, that is amplified to the extreme. Her semblance, called Hype, is simply to supercharge her bullets with aura. And that's why that a single bullet can just rip through Nevermore's, rip through other Grimm, and is incredibly powerful. Now, this also goes to how Coco is an extremely strong person, because if the bullet is coming out with that much more force and power, the recoil on it is going to be that much stronger as well. We see in Volume 2 that Coco fires this gun, this giant Gatling gun that she carries around, and isn't pushed back barely at all by it. She's a very strong person, and her semblance is incredibly strong. Although, if she runs out of bullets, then that kind of poses a problem. And After the Fall, she really only used her semblance to charge up bullets, but her own bullets, that being. But I wonder if her semblance could be used in a different way. If it could be used to amplify the power of a sword swing, for example. Because instead of her semblance just being able to amplify aura in bullets, it seems like it's able to amplify aura, or at least supercharge aura, in the conduits of aura, that being the weapons that people use, that the Huntsman and Huntress use to slay the Grimm. So she's able to use her semblance to supercharge, for example, Yatsuhashi's weapon, whereas with one swing he can already shatter the ground. Imagine if that power was amplified tenfold. Yeah, the shockwave sent out by that would be more than enough to send Grimm just flying back. It would probably be enough to kill them outright and potentially level a city, but yeah, that would be pretty interesting. Not to mention if she was able to use this in a wide fashion, potentially in an army setting. If there is a war that breaks out and she's able to amplify the aura of her allies, then, you know, that could work out very well. And I say this, that she wouldn't necessarily need to be in contact with the people, as, you know, aura charging your bullets, they stay charged even once they've left the gun and left contact with your person, so I believe that her semblance might be able to work even if she was just close to someone and they were firing off bullets or things like that. It would be interesting to see how it would be used in the future. Now, when it comes to Velvet, we've actually seen her use Coco's Gatling gun, using her camera to imitate the weapon and fire it against an Elysian Paladin. Except when it was against the Elysian Paladin, it did not do really much of anything. It slowed it down a little bit, but it's not like it blasted it apart or anything like Coco's Gatling gun actually would do. And that's because Velvet didn't have Coco's semblance. When I saw that in the series itself, I figured just because the weapon was an imitation, not the actual Gatling gun itself, didn't hold the same weight or had actual, you know, metallic or dust bullets, I thought that there was, maybe that was the reason why it wasn't doing as much damage. But no, it was actually because Velvet didn't have Coco's semblance. But Velvet's semblance fits perfectly with her photograph weapon that she uses to imitate everyone else's weapons. And I never really thought about it much at the time, but Velvet not only imitated people's weapons, she perfectly imitated people's fighting styles. And that's because Velvet's semblance is photographic memory. She sees someone's fighting style once and is able to remember it and imitate it perfectly, completely bypassing the years of experience needed to master said fighting technique. For example, RWBY's scythe, as Ozpin stated in the beginning of Volume 1 itself, that it's one of the most deadly weapons known to man, you know, in hand-to-hand combat that being. Velvet is able to imitate that perfectly, as we saw in Volume 3 when she was fighting that paladin. It's was an incredible thing to see, and Velvet is just an amazing character, but with her semblance being photographic memory, that skyrockets her even further. If she could remember more than just fighting styles, which I'm guessing she can, although wasn't really gone into in that aspect, if she's able to listen to a lecture once and be able to remember it, or just read a book and be able to remember all the information in it, recall that information and be able to expand upon that, she could become one of the most brilliant people in the world of Remnant, not to mention the most skilled. Now, it's really only demonstrated in After the Fall and in the RWBY series itself that when Velvet uses her semblance, photographic memory, she's only using it in tandem with the weapons that she has. So she has certain weapons equipped, and she uses that set person's fighting style with those weapons. Now, after she's expanded upon her memory, learned hundreds of different fighting styles, as now she's been at Beacon Academy, seen everyone fighting at the Vital Fighting Festival, now at Shade Academy, seeing how everyone trains and fights there, not to mention being out on various missions, seeing other people fight. She's probably seen numerous different fighting styles. It would be really interesting to see if she could remember all of them and be able to mix and match them in sort of a way that utilizing one person's weapon, use it in a style that would be unexpected, or that the person who has trained with that weapon for however many years hadn't actually thought of doing, or being able to use all these hundreds of years of accumulated skill that she has in her mind and be able to expand upon that. Now, maybe there's a limit to how much her brain can actually contain at one time, but there's no implication that that's the case. So Velvet could become one of the most powerful people in Remnant, or at least not necessarily one of the most powerful, but one of the most skilled huntresses ever, just based on her semblance, being able to see something, someone who's trained for 50 years or however long, and being able to learn from that just by seeing it and be able to imitate those fighting styles and possibly being able to remember all that knowledge. That would be incredible. I could easily see Velvet becoming a headmaster of one of the schools later on in the world of Remnant, depending on how things, you know, shape out, that the Huntsman School survive past the end of the RWBY series or anything like that, because you never know once the relics are all taken away, or at the end of the series when the relics end up disappearing after the gods and everything, there might not be any schools left, there may not be Grimm, and there might not be a need for Huntsmen and Huntresses. We don't exactly know, but that's definitely a potential route I could see for Velvet, because she would be able to train anyone, be able to match their fighting styles, and know exactly what they need. Velvet is an incredible person in the RWBY series, so yeah, that's a lot of potential that she has and could go forward into the future. Now lastly, let's talk about Fox Alistair, the comedic relief of Team Coffee. Surprisingly enough, that's something I did not expect. Someone who barely talked, if at all, throughout Volumes 2 and 3 when we saw him. And just a note and confirmation that he is in fact blind. I had suspicions based on, you know, his eyes being completely white that he was actually blind, but there wasn't confirmation until after the fall. I thought that he might be a unique type of Faunus that had just sheer white eyes or something like that, but he is in fact blind and has been blind since birth. But because he's blind, that does not mean that he cannot see. He is essentially the Daredevil of the RWBY universe, but not to the same extent. It's not like his senses were heightened to the point where he can just see the world around him based on sound. Though his senses are heightened, he uses his semblance to actually see around him. Now, his semblance is telepathy. He can communicate telepathically with all of his comrades and selectively choose who he communicates with. Now, this is very useful, and the entire reason why he doesn't talk throughout Volumes 2 and 3. He's been communicating with his team telepathically, and that's why we don't hear him talk. He can communicate with his team knows exactly what's going on, what he's planning to do, what he's thinking, etc., so he has no need to talk. Plus, he's also awkward in new social situations, so there's that as well. Now, Fox can not only communicate telepathically, but he can simply sense other people's minds. And after the fall, he ran out in the desert searching for people who had just ran off on their own. And he was able to find them quite easily, as once he gets within a certain range, he can sense their minds. No matter how weak it is, or however far, or however hidden they may be, he can sense their minds once he's within range. And his telepathy does have a range, so it does, if he's far enough away from his team, he can't communicate with them, etc. But he has a very powerful semblance that works very well for him, as, you know, he can't see, so he can use that to locate people, and along with assistance from his scroll that tells him spatial information around himself, so he can see, okay, there's people here, there's people attacking me, there's walls here, etc., can get some spatial awareness, but his semblance helps him the most. And he can communicate, it's a two-way street. He opens up a channel to different people. So he can open up a channel between his entire team, and they don't even have to talk to one another to be able to understand what each other is saying and thinking. So if we ever see Team Coffee again, or we will see Team Coffee again in the RWBY series, but if they aren't really speaking to one another, and they're just wandering around, but they know exactly where each other's going, and it seems like they know what each other's thinking, it's because they do. It's because Fox's semblance is telepathy. Now, this semblance, how it could be expanded upon, of course, there's a greater range, being able to sense people's minds from a farther distance, and possibly being able to not really manipulate people's minds, but have a sense of persuasion on them. That would more be akin to Fox's ability to persuade people and be a little bit of a silver tongue, as we know that he's able to communicate with people even if they don't really want to be communicated with. In After the Fall, there was a situation where the entire town started fighting with one another, and screaming at them wasn't going to get anything done. But, you know, screaming directly right into their head will definitely get the job done. Fox did it accidentally, but an entire settlement of over 100 people, he yelled at to shut up and gave everyone a moment of pause, as, of course, when a voice just all of a sudden yells into your head, it would do the trick. But with Fox's semblance, it would be really interesting to see how it would evolve. Telepathy is not really something you think about becoming more and more powerful as life progresses on. It's just more getting skilled at using it and being able to use it on multiple people, expand the range, things like that. So that's one I'm interested to hear what your guys' ideas are with Fox's semblance, Velvet's, and Coco's as well. How do you think they will expand as the RWBY series continues? How do you think they're going to grow stronger? And also, what do you think of their semblances in general? Did you guys know about their semblances before After the Fall came out? Also, have you guys read After the Fall, and did you enjoy the book itself? Let me know down in the comments below. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy this video, make sure to subscribe and let me know what else you'd like to see in the future. There's still more After the Fall content coming, plus, of course, other RWBY content, so look forward to that. And I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next one.